Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. From out of nowhere, Felina has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for, one little kiss and Felina goodbye.
All my friends know the low rider. The low rider is a little higher.
It's so good to be here, man. I've been here many, many, many times. I used to come here as a kid. We had relatives here. At least I think they were relatives, you know. You know, Mexican relatives is anybody who stayed overnight. Hey, Mom, who's that guy on the couch? Oh, that's your Uncle Rudy. You grow up like that, man. I love this place, except it's hot. It's like hell's waiting room, man. Damn, is it that cheaper to live here, man? I love Texas. I love El Paso. We got the East Coast and we got the West Coast, and now we got the Third Coast right here, buddy. I want to say hi to all my homies out front. Told you to buy tickets, man. I told you to buy tickets. Yeah. Hey, how do you like this set, huh? Pretty cool. I don't care if you're Mexican or Puerto Rican or Cubano, you all came from a neighborhood like this at one time or another. My parents used to live on the second floor, so they didn't get bugged by the Jehovah's Witnesses, man. All right, well, let's get this show on the road, man. We got a great show for you. You're going to laugh your ass off. The first guy we're going to bring out now from New York City, a former prize fighter, so no le chingas. Lightweight, he was on Showtime, he was on HBO. Let's give it up for Joey Medina from New York City.
Let me hear you.
El Paso, Texas, the capital of what is Mexico? That's what.
There's no shortage of chiclets in fucking Mexico. No, 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 no. Every 2 feet, get a chiclets, get a chiclets, get a chiclets. I want you to leave me alone. Get a chiclets, get a chiclets. I love Mexico. I love driving across, because you ever notice when you drive across, you got Mexican immigration checking us out? And I'm thinking, what if Fred, we're sneaking in technology? Ooh. You, senor with the laptop, get out of the car. It's not a laptop, pendejo, it's an Etch-a-Sketch, look. There's no mouse, pendejo, it's, you know. And the best thing I love about Mexico is you can drink for like $5 all fucking night. Yeah. Corona's a dollar, tequila's 50 cents, NyQuil's a quarter, you can get loaded. I had $5, I got loaded the other day. I'm like, woo, Mexico's number one, woo, woo, Mexico's the bomb, woo, I love Mexico. I got so drunk that I passed out and woke up in a Mexican jail. Talking about, I'm an American.
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. I'm a Yankee Doodle Boy.
My bail was $10 in my Nikes. What kind of shit was that? And where else are you gonna get 10 tacos for a dollar? But I was thinking, I'm like, 10 tacos, what kind of meat are we eating? You bite into a taco and get a dog tag. Hey, what's this? The guy gets so nervous, so that's a surprise. Congratulations. Ding, 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 we got a winner. Ding, 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 ding. Who the hell's Fido? No, that's Fidel. Oh, okay, thank you very much. Shit, I love everything about Mexico, man. I played this game in Vegas last time I was there called Mexican Poker. They're naming games after minorities now. What's next? Who you calling Blackjack? Junta Kino? That's screwed up. Before you know it, they're gonna have a slot machine. You can put a food stamp right in it. You pull the handles like sandwich? Sandwich? Ah, cigarettes. I lost again. Shit. Come on, honey, let's go to the wick machine and spin for some milk. Come on, Nita. Let's win some of that government housing. And you don't even need to go to Vegas. If you like gambling, just go to Indian casinos. They're everywhere. They're here in Texas. They're everywhere. And I love American Indians. And I love what they're doing, you know, with the casinos, because it wasn't too long ago we were getting them drunk and taking their shit. Now they're doing it to us. I admire American Indians so much. They're so proud. They're so proud of the culture. If you insult their culture, they'll sue you. They don't give a shit. They will sue you and everybody in your family. They sued Crayola Crayons because Crayola Crayons has a crayon called what? Indian Red. And I'm a minority. I don't give a shit if they had Lazy Brown, Unemployed Black, Can't Drive for Shit Yellow. Trailer Trash White, make your fucking crowns. As long as I stay within the lines. That's the beauty of this country, is that we come in different cultures, different colors and races. Like, I celebrate other people's cultures. I'm Puerto Rican, but Cinco de Mayo, I'm Mexican. St. Patrick's Day, I'm Irish. Black History Month, I have sex with white girls. I do. And that's a whole month long, suke suke now. African Americans have gone so far, they've done so much. Nowadays, they're stronger and wealthier and more successful than they ever were. They're so confident, they greet each other with an insult. Doesn't even bother them. What's up, my nigga? I'm just chilling. You don't see Latinos talking like that. ¿Qué pasa, wey, pack? Ay, tú sabes. Aquí estoy, speak, tú sabes. You don't see white people talk about, hey, honky, how's it going? Well, I'm doing good, cracker, just keeping the black and brown man down. Well, that's what I'm doing. See some Asian guy talking about, hello, my yellow electronic making egg foo young motherfucker, what's up? I love it. I wish I was black, because black people do shit that don't make sense sometimes. My best friend Dean is black. He got a tattoo. Isn't that like skywriting at night? I swear to God, it's just... I never understood this myth about black men that they don't give their women oral pleasure. No, but they eat pig's feet. Excuse me. I mean, I don't know. On one hand, you got pussy. The other hand, you got a pig's foot. You decide. I'll take the one that's less salty. Thank you very much. in this country, it's really like poor people that get exploited. You know, you go to any ghetto, you go to any bad neighborhood, they don't have shiny, brand new banks. They got check cashing places. And I actually like them better than banks, because that's the only place in the world you can, like, cash a check, pay your phone bill, and buy tortillas all in the same fucking building. And I love the way the little old ladies sell tortillas here in El Paso. They sell it like they're selling crack, being real sneaky. You walk by and hear, pss, pss,
pss. Tortillas? Tamales.
What if she had the chimichanga, cochina? That's what the hell I want to know. And when you get money, you actually change a little bit. Money changes people. You ever notice how rich people brag about how much money they spend? Yet us poor people, we brag about how much money we save. Rich person goes, you see this shirt? Giorgio Armani. $2,000. These shoes, Versace. $600. When you don't got money, he's like, that ain't shit. See, these shoes pay less, 2 for $10. See, his shirt, Kmart, $11.95. That ain't all. You see these pants? I borrowed them, never gave it back. What's up? All these couples here, I'm getting all horny, just looking at you people. I'm a freak, man. I got some of that Viagra for a dollar over there in Mexico. And it's... I'm like MacGyver when it comes to sex. Give me duct tape and a midget and someone's getting fucked. That's all I'm saying. I just... And women are just as kinky as men. I know they are because I read it in Cosmo, so it's got to be true. Because women will ask things in bed to a man that the man will never ask. You know, Joey, tell me your fantasy. No, you get mad. But while you're making love, it's okay. While you're making love, it's okay. Because, you know, you can talk about anything. No, Joey, tell me. I don't care. Tell me your fantasy. Tell me. Okay, I want you and your sister. What are you going to do to us? I'm going to go crazy. But as soon as the sex is over, it's like, you want to fuck my sister? And women do things just like women play. Women do the masturbation thing. Not as good as men, because we figure out... I dance, I put Kenny G, I light candles. I'm like, what's up, papi, what's up? I play hard to get. Hey, what? Don't look at me when I talk to you. What? Oh, you mad because I scratched my ass with the other hand that day? That was just a piece of ass. That didn't mean nothing to me, baby. You're the one I love. Women use toys and everything. And don't get me wrong. I buy my women toys. I do. But guys, be smart. If you buy your woman a toy, make sure it's not bigger than you. That's all I'm saying. Hello, vibrator, goodbye you. Buy those little ones with like a watch battery. Like, that's it. That's what you need now, mijita. Look, it's got fingers and everything. Oh, they use that shower massage thing. That shower head. They pretend they're gonna take a shower for 2 hours.
Joey Medina, ladies and gentlemen, Joey Medina. Joey Medina. I love walking around the streets of life. I've been here about 2-3 days. I've been walking around the streets of El Paso, you know, and everybody's really friendly and they want autographs and post for a million pictures. Except everybody thinks they're in show business. So one cholo hanging around the bus says, hey, ¿Sabes qué? I can do impressions. Oh, well, that's cool, man. No, hey, vato, I can do impressions. Want to hear a dog? Yeah, all right, let me hear a dog. Well, yeah, that's great, man. Okay, no, hey, you want to hear a cat? Sure, I want to hear a cat. Meow, meow, meow. Oh, that's great. So, hey, you want to hear a wolf? Okay, man, let's hear a wolf. Well, I don't really do it. My grandmother does it. Mira, abuelita, ven pa' acá. Mira, grandma, how long has it been since you had sex? Woo! I have waited to come to El Paso to tell that joke, man. All right, we're going to keep the show rolling with a guy who was born in Acapulco, raised here in Texas, and now lives in Kentucky. I'm thinking witness protection program. Let's give it up for Alex Raimundo.
Suavemente, bésame. Yo quiero sentir tus labios besándome.
El paso, let me hear you.
Bésame, 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 bésame. Yo quiero sentir tus labios.
El Paso, Texas. Beautiful, beautiful city. Yeah. Looks like dirt from the airplane, but it's a beautiful city. Your town slogan should be El Paso, just add water. A beautiful city with beautiful women. Look at these ladies here tonight. Mira, preciosas. You know what I like to see? I like to look around there. I like to see the men with their arms around their ladies. Right, because if you're a man and there's a woman in your life, this is you part of the day. Right, everywhere we go, that's my girl right there. Go on, check her out. That's long enough, fucker. I shouldn't talk about it. It's not my lifestyle. But you know what frightens me? Y'all, the thought of going to jail. All right, there's my lifestyle. Yours too. You go to jail, guess what? Up the fanny, buddy. Yeah, they're not even gay. They're just bored. Not me, buddy. I have a plan. I've thought it over. If I ever end up in jail, I'm going to shit my pants every day I'm in there. I'll shit my pants and rub it all over my ass. Oh, go away! All right, I'll be the dirtiest, nastiest, stinkiest motherfucker in cell block D. It'll be a chore to fuck me, I'll tell you that right now. There'll be guys looking at me, hey, you got to wash him first. I will stink, but my father will be proud. He's like, hey, well, he failed, but he's a good boy. And the arm's still there. Look around the room, everywhere you go. Had a big theater like this for a long drive in the car, even while we sleep at night. I love you, baby. My arm is fucking numb, but I love you. No te mueves, because it'll break off. Right? What we don't realize is half of you ladies are down there going real fucking comfortable. Crick in my neck, as long as it makes you feel like the macho shit you think you are. Men are retarded, aren't we, ladies? Yeah, but you're still fucking us, so what does that say about you? Men are retarded, ladies. Men have two things on their mind. We're thinking, there's only two things. We're thinking about getting laid and getting laid later. That's it. You know, but there's a big difference between men and women. We do things. We live by a different set of rules. We live by the same laws, but we live by a different set of rules, don't we? Sure, we do. Girls get away with a little more, I believe. I've never gotten out of a ticket in my life. I get pulled over, what happens? I get a ticket or I go to jail. Depends on how many warrants I have out for my arrest. My sister gets pulled over. She's a beautiful girl. Was that speeding? We can't do that, can we, man? What are we gonna do? You married, officer? Porque yo estaba pensando que maybe, you know. Míralos. Tantillos. All right, the cop's looking at me. Hey, you might want to save that for prison, son. Women do things men can't do. Women fix each other's hair. Hey, me pones una trenza? Would you braid my hair?
You ever fix your buddy's hair? What the fuck would you do if he asked you, hey, dude, can you do something with my hair, bro? Pendejo, si estás pelón. Women share clothes. Oh, my God, that is so pretty. Can I wear it? You ever wear your buddy's clothes? Why? Because it's dirty. All right, last time I checked, your stench plus mine equals no pussy. Women pee together. You want to go pee? You don't even have to know the guy. I don't know you, but you want to pee with me? He said, I remember that, holding hands, singing songs. Why are you peeing together? Because it's scary in there. Why are you peeing together? Because the line is really long. Well, no shit, Chiquita, you're taking all your friends. Men don't pee. A lady got mad at me last night. She goes, what if I run out of paper? I was like, what's your friend gonna do, blow you dry? I don't understand. Could you see that? If you need that done, take your man. He'll do that for you.
Hey, you're still wet. We're gonna be here all night.
You've been married a long time. How long you been married? Mamacita. Como que no? 37 years. Yeah, I know. Fuck yeah. You suck your man's dick, don't you? It's okay. Don't be ashamed. You're not a puta sucia. You're a good woman. You're communicating with him. You see people in marriage counseling all the time. He never talks to me. Really? Suck his dick. He'll talk to you. He might be, ooh, 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 but he's talking. Sucky cocky, it's okay. And men, return the favor. Fa la 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 la. That's what it's all about. Don't be ashamed of it. Sucky cocky. Right? Your mama did it. Yes, she did. Sucked your daddy's dick. Probably a couple others. Stop me when I lie. Your beautiful querida abuelita did it. Yeah. In the day of the Depression, when there was nothing to be happy about, nothing to eat. She didn't go hungry. Your great-great-grandma did it in a wagon train. Wagon ho, bitch. Stop me when I lie. You know what pisses me off? People say Mexicans are lazy. Right? That's bullshit, isn't it? That is bullshit. My father came to this country with 5 children, $4, and 3 jobs. That ain't lazy, that's fucked. But he made it work, you know why? Because he's a hard goddamn worker. He works hard. He moved us into white neighborhoods. We never knew the fucking difference. He worked his ass off all the time. But you know what? He worked hard, but he just never had the right tools. Now, he never used them. Like if you had something to be fixed in the backyard, he'd go, hey, Dad, we better go to Home Depot. Home Depot, fuck that. Cabrón, traigo pinzas. Duct tape and brick. The brick will hold it up. The duct tape holds it in. It's like, you ought to try that on mom's ass. My dad. We're not lazy. That's bullshit. We're not lazy. Me and my brother have a restaurant called La Chocita, a little Mexican restaurant. And on the window, on the storefront, just like this, we had a guy come in, an artist, paint a little mural, right? A montaña with a valley like that, little nopalito. And I said, put me a little Mexican right there next to a nopalito, sleeping, taking a siesta. My dad came in, he saw it, he goes, oh, cabrón. ¿Qué chingados es eso? That's La Chocita, Dad, a little valley in Mexicano taking a siesta. Siesta, goddamn, I never took no fucking siesta. I know all my life, 3 goddamn jobs, I never take. That's why pendejos think we're lazy, because of bullshit like that. Quítame ese hijo de la chingada de allí. We had to scrape it off, We repainted and we put him back on there. We fucking put him pulling a plow, walking a dog, beeper going off. Bolillos come in. What the fuck is that? That's a busy fucking Mexican. That's what that is. Thank you very much. God bless you. Good night.
Alex Raimundo. Let's hear for him. Alex Raimundo. Alex Raimundo. Woo!
Cabron is all wet, too, man. In the ear. That was the only place he didn't talk about. I was telling you earlier that I used to come to El Paso all the time when I was a kid. I remember one time I was here and I was like right between like 12 and 13. I was going through puberty and, you know, I was getting all manly, man. It was the first time I ever knew that Mexicanos called their dicks chiles, you know? So, yeah, pero un chile. Okay, all right. So I was in the men's room one time at the show, and I was sitting there, and a big Tejano walks in next to me, a big 10-gallon hat, cowboy boots. He goes, pretty chilly. I go, oh, thanks, mister.
All right, man, it's time to bring out my homeboy. He really is my homeboy. He's from my hometown, San Fernando, California. I know you've seen him on TV a lot of times, man. I've watched him grow and grow and grow, and now he has arrived. Will you please welcome my homeboy, George Lopez?
La cosa que quiero decir. Thank you. First, I'd like to say, I must have hit the SAP button by mistake. Let me translate. Gracias a venir al show, este pinche pueblo de güeros, cabrones, que se dan las nalgas, pinches gringos, cabrones, que se van a la chinga. I want to thank you all so much for coming out tonight and supporting Latino comedy. Thank you so much. I want to thank my man Cheech Marin and Paul Rodriguez for having me on the show. Pinche güeros que se van para atrás a sus trailer parks, hijo de sus chingas. And I realize that there are problems within our communities, and I know that one day, through patience and understanding, we can bridge the gaps. Y si no, cabrones, que me mamen la verga, pinches güeros, cabrones. And we can allow the healing to begin. All right! Look at the people that don't speak Spanish. What's going on? What's he talking about, Reed? I don't know. Let me greet you with the Mexican hello. That's how we say hello. Hey, George, I want you to meet my family. Oh, shit. Don't forget your cousin in the wheelchair. Does all Mexican families have a relative in the wheelchair? If you don't have one, let me know. I'll get you one. And it's never a good wheelchair. Todo rompido, buen llantato. And somebody has to push him. He can't push himself, your grandma. Push your cousin. Push your cabrón. Push your cousin. You should be happy your legs work, cabrón. Push your cousin. That's how we say hello. Somebody we haven't seen in 20 years. And it's never happy. Not a long time no see. Mexican, where you been, puto? Push it, my cousin. Somebody's far away. Come in and say hi to me. Fuck, I went like that. You turned away before I came back up. Is that what? Wait for me, man. Wait for me. Because that's the way we are. We grow up so insecure. It's always, wait for me. You forget something? Oh, shit, I forgot my jacket. Hey, wait for me. Not, I'll be right back. Hey, I got my keys in there. Wait for me, man. Don't wait for me. Why are we like that? Because when you're a little kid, you have to go pee. What does your mom say? Hurry up, come on, because we're not going to wait for you. You ever have that crazy aunt that whenever she drinks, they pee anywhere? Right there, by the time you turn around, she's already down. Tápame, tápame, tápame. Hey! Ese salió con premio. And what do? They're so fucked up they tuck their dress in the pantyhose. Ay. Piche bailando en la noche, ¿eh? Ay, mira, Rafi, everyone's looking at me. Ay. And nobody says anything. Mira, tía, tiene el vestido ahí. Leave her like that. That's what she learns. Everything that happens to us is so we'll learn. You get hit, cabrón. Sit right there. That way you'll learn. Siéntate. And we're always all right. We're so afraid of making trouble. We're always all right. You can get hit by a car. Bam! Are you all right? I'm all right. Don't fucking work on the front yard. Ay. Ay. I'm all right, señora. No, estoy bien. They're going to run my social security number. I'm all right. And what are we always doing? Nothing. What are we? Hey, what are you doing over there? Nothing. We're never doing nothing. Hey. What'd you do this weekend? Nothing. Latinos are direct opposites of everybody else. Some people are happy to see other people. They wave them over. Oh, my God! Look, everyone, it's Duncan. Duncan! Oh, my God! We're totally over here. Duncan! You're 9 feet away. They call you on the cell phone. Oh, my God! I'm totally right here. Latinos are never happy. We look, oh, fuck, look who's over there, man. Son of a bitch. Hide the chair, hide the chair, hide the chair. Hide the chair. Don't look over there, don't look over there, don't look over there. Pretend we're talking, cabrón, pretend we're talking. Look at my face, cabrón, pretend we're talking. He saw me? Shit, he saw me? Liar, say swear to God, swear to God. Swear to God. Come on in, you saw me. Fuck, you might as well. We're different people. Some people won't wait in line. They'll see a line, oh God, there is a line. Mexican, we're waiting in line, we don't even know what the line's for. Mira la línea, chinga su madre. Go get in line, go get in line. And once you get in, you let everyone in. Tia, písale, cabrona. They're not gonna get you. Come on. Different people. We're not happy for anybody. A true Latino is never happy when other people do well. Our first instinct is negative. Did you hear Ruben got a job at the hospital? The marijuana? Órale. Pinche marijuana working at the hospital? Shit. I'm gonna call up, watch. Hello, hospital? Ruben's a marijuana over. That way he'll learn. My grandmother, I learned from my grandma. My grandma, 82 years old, everything she says is negative. Everything. Grandma, you hear about Maria? What, that she's pregnant? No, she's getting married. Like I said. With blue eyeshadow. So you can see it, they keep their eyes closed. Are you gonna go to the wedding? Shh. I went to the first three. Nada más puta que la chingada. She got four kids getting married in a white dress. Tan loca la cabrona, white dress. No, hombre. A white dress. Mira that white dress. She should get married in a white dress with black sleeves. And a hole in the front, pa' cabale chingada. But tell her I said hi. Bring me a plate. That's all I want. We never say congratulations. You ever see people, man, that are happy for other people? Oh, God, you're awesome. Congratulations. You rock. We never say congratulations. What do we say? Oh, so now I think you're up bad or what? ¿Te crees muy chingón? We'll still kick your ass. Yeah, go to the Hallmark store and look for that card. Can I help you, sir? Yeah, you don't have a night thing, you're up bad card? Liar, say swear to God. Swear to God? How about a you ain't shit balloon? You don't have one of those? Shit, you guys don't have nothing here. We need our own greeting cards. We need Mexicano greeting cards because the ones at the stores are too happy. We don't understand that. You need one that says, heard about your new job. You open it up. Don't fuck it up like the last time. We're tough from the time we're kids. You get that tough love. Little babies cry, the mothers run over. Oh my God, Caitlin, are you all right? Us. Mira, there he goes. Chille, chille, no mo chingue del bebé. Hombre, let him cry, mija, let him cry. It's good for his lungs, let him cry. Let him cry. Turn the music up, I don't need to hear this shit. Turn that music. Then they go pick you up. Don't pick him up. Don't pick him up. He's going to get used to it. Don't pick him up. No, but now you fucked him up. No, now he's going to want you to hold him and change him. No, hombre. You may as well have another one because you messed that one up. Different people. We trick you into helping. We wait till you sit down. Ruben, what are you doing right now? Right now, I'm not doing nothing. Help me fix my truck. I gotta pull the transmission out and put a new one in. Oh, you mean right now, right now? Yeah. I can't do it right now, right now. When? Shit, probably later. Later, later. But not right now, right now. You should have told me before. whole school, we're always late. We're late because none of the clocks work in our houses. They all need batteries. The TV is the clock. It's always on. Grandma, when do you take your medicine?
Cuando se acaba la Judge Judy, I take my pill.
We don't have clocks in the house. All we have is calendars from every panería we've ever been to. On the walls, every wall. And it's the same picture, the Aztec dude and the dead lady. And your grandma doesn't want to take it down. That reminds me of me when I was young. Porque me gustaba pistear, and I used to, they used to bring me home like that, barefoot, with a flower in my hair. Toda encuerada. I never had a water hose at my house that had the metal end. You know? It was always cut and cut. The minute I had a hole over here, they cut. Cortalo, cabrón. Bitch, your hose was this long. I wanted a nozzle. My grandpa like, you got a thumb, you got a nozzle. Mira. How do I turn it off? Pinch it, mira. Off. On. Chinga su madre, mira. Pinch it. Off. On. Pégale. Up. I didn't have swim trunks. I used to cut pants. You ever used to cut pants? Hey, if you want to go swimming, cut pants. Then you'd find the scissors and some old pants. Are we going for reals? For reals. Because if I cut, I can't cut back. For reals? Say swear to God. Swear to God. Or used to go swimming in your underwear, the tantarans, remember the tantaran, tantaran? The white briefs, tantaran. You'd run around the house with a towel and a clothespin. Tantaran. And your mom still thinks you're the tantaran boy. You're 34 years old. Todo borracha la cabrón, mijo, tú la tantaran. Do the tantaran! With feeling, cabrón, I don't believe you. Tantaran! Mira, te salió un huevo, cabrón. Por ahí. Oh my God, cochino. With un huevo salido, popped out. Mira, put it back in. And when did you get hair, cochino? We never believe when anybody's sick. And when they are sick, they never go to the doctor. Man, I feel bad. I should go to the doctor. Shit, you better not go. They're going to find something wrong with you. Don't go. If I were you, I wouldn't go. Drink a 7-Up, you'll be all right. Tómate un 7. Drink a 7-Up. And burp it out. Mira, chingate todo el bote. Y luego, y sale el cáncer con el burp, mira. Put a lemon, pon un limón, y luego chingate. We drink too much. We drink to get drunk. Then we call women up in the middle of the night. Hey, 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 hey. What are you doing? Sleeping. Cochina. Let me come more. Right now, right now. Hey, hey, what are your chichis doing? If you let me come over, I'll go down there.
No, this time for reals. Because you're a cochina. You liked it. You liked it. You liked it. You liked it. When you got on top and you were moving the... Oh, I'm sorry, senora. Is Gloria there? Different people. We've taken over the country. If you ain't go to any fast food restaurant, it's all Latinos that work there. You have to be bilingual to get a hamburger. You ever go to Jack in the Box and the voice that comes out of the speaker has a Mexican accent? What to Jack in the Box and I take your order? The fuck's going on in there? What to Jack in the Box and I take your order? Quiere algo, cabrón? You want a sanction? Is this Jack in the Box? Yes, can I have a Jumbo Jack? You want a Jumbo Jack? Quieres she? You want she? Quieres queso? You want she? I better not. Quieres papa frita? You want fran fran? Papa frita? No papa fritas, thanks. Then they lose everybody in Jack in the Box. What kind of fountain drinks do you have? What kind of fountain drinks do you have? Keke? Fountain drinks. 1 minute, please. Ramon, este vato me está diciendo fountain drink. ¿Qué es eso? Este pinche mamón en la ventana me está diciendo fountain drink, muy chingón. ¿Qué? ¿Es soda? ¿Es soda? ¿Es soda? Míralo, cabrón. ¡Ey! ¿Why you not say soda, stupid? Sí, tenemos soda, tenemos coca, tenemos Pepsi, Sprite, Mr. Peep. Then they got all the Mexicans. Jamaica, tamarindo, chaparrada, horchata. I don't want to know who works there, fucker. I want something to drink. We do everything by memory. All Latinos. It's all memory. Remember that time we went? You remember? You don't remember? You got drunk and you threw up outside. You don't remember? You mama. We don't have pictures, we take pictures, we just never develop the film. They just hold up the film. Mira, these are when you were little. They said Fuchi. But things are changing, things get better. What's happening now is a lot of Latinas are raising little kids. You know, there's a Latino in every home, whether you live there or you work there. They come in and raise these kids for these ladies that want to work. There was always somebody in our house raising us, so they raise their kids and they raise other kids, little white kids that are gonna understand Latinos because they're gonna have brown hearts because the person that's spending all the time with them, Socorro, is teaching them. And they're gonna speak Spanish. Austin, bájate de ahí, cabrón, bájate. Oh. Con permiso, socorro. And when they fall, they're gonna get what we got when we fell. Mira, go to the top, cabrón, and fall all the way down. So you can break your head wide open. Súbale, súbale. And when that mother tries to discipline her kid, it's not going to work because she's not there. She's going to come home, come here this instant. I didn't even do nothing. You come here right now. Right now, right now.
And when that kid walks for the first time and talks for the first time, the mother's not going to be there. Socorro's going to be there. She's going to have to hear about it that day. Señora, mira, today that baby estaba walking, walking. I'm sorry, no Nintendo. Estaba, mira, el bebé, Austin, estaba walking, mira, walking. Y también talking, mira, pick, pick. Oh my God! Austin was walking and talking? Te estoy diciendo, cabrona, que estaba andando y estaba hablando. Did you get the video camera? Did you videotape it? Shit, what for? I'll remember. Gracias. I love you guys. Cuídense. Thank you very much. I love you. Gracias.
George Lopez. George Lopez, ladies and gentlemen. Culero, culero.
Ah, damn. Oh, God. It's great living here right next to the border, man. I want to ask you a question because I've been having a debate with a lot of people. Like, what do we want to be called? How many in this audience tonight want to be known as Hispanics? Okay, that's cool. Not many. How many want to be known as Latinos? Few more. How many want to be known as Chicanos? Well, before we were Hispanics and before we were Latinos, before we were Chicanos, we were Mexican-Americans! And Mexican-Americans don't like to get up early in the morning, but they have to, so they do it real slow. And Mexican-Americans love education, so they go to night school and they take Spanish and get a B. And Mexican-Americans don't like to just get into gang fights. They like flowers and music and white girls named Debbie, too. And Mexican-Americans are named Chata and Chela and Chema and Chewy and have a son-in-law named Jeff. The same for Mexican-Americans, too.
Oh, boy. Hey, man, it's such a pleasure to be back here in Texas. We used to come to Texas a lot. Cheech and Chong broke out of Texas in San Antonio. We're very proud of it. And then we came to Chuco, man, El Chuco. I just found out Paul was telling me it was Chuco's, the meeting place. And how they got Pachucos. Well, pues, ¿dónde vas, Pachuco? That's very amazing. This is a Tarumara meeting place. This is where they all met. Here's a very sacred ground here. You should all be proud to live here in El Paso. Okay, here's the guy you've been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for El Jefe, Paul Rodriguez.
Getting parking is a bitch around here.
Big Chuco! Who's your daddy?
Put on your seatbelts, it's gonna be a bumpy ride. I love El Paso. People bitch about the weather, I say it's preparing me for hell. I like the hot weather, man. People die of heat exhaustion. Dying of heat exhaustion has got to be the dumbest thing you can do. Because there's no reason for it. Take your ass to a supermarket. Lay on the frozen fish section. Hijo de la chingada. Some lady's going,
Is there any fish? Aquí está el catch of the day. And it's already been breaded for you. Órale. Think of it as Mrs. Paul's. And weather affects us. When it's cold, it only makes women sex you. Your nipples get hard. Women are always doing this at concerts, you know. They always cover themselves. They're outside. They got the mini skirt. You know, they always ask, is it cold or is it me? Just move your hands. Let me see your nipples. I don't know. When it gets cold, you get sexier. For men, when it gets cold, our nuts disappear. I was in Chicago. It was 10 below zero. My balls went up into my stomach. I didn't even know they had a garage. It gets cold, man. It does terrible things to your penis. You're out there apologizing, going, no, really, it's not like that all the time. You don't have any balls. And your dick looks like an eraser. And when it gets hot, the opposite happens. When it gets hot, your huevos droop down. And the older you get, the further they droop. On my mother's side, they live forever. My grandpa, man, on a hot day, like here in El Paso, his balls would come out of his pant legs. He'd walk around the house and he'd step on his nuts. Hijo de la chingada. I step on my nuts. Hey, somebody give me some duct tape. I love my grandpa, man, but when he went to the toilet, his balls would fall in the water. And he'd holler at my mom, Maria! Maria, my nuts are tengo los huevos en el agua. And my mother's cooking, going, well, don't flush, Dad. Don't flush, shit. I don't know where it'll wind up. It'll wind up on the Gulf of Mexico someplace. My mother would actually call me, come here, Paul. Ben, go help your grandpa. Hell, what the hell am I gonna do for you? Here, take this wooden spoon that I bought in Juarez. Go over there and get his huevos out of the water. And hurry up and bring me the spoon, I'm cooking. We are trying to find a woman like our mother, subconsciously or consciously. We are. And it's hard because they don't make them like that anymore. You know, when our mother was young, my mother used to buy chickens for 5 cents. And she would raise them and would tell us, those aren't pets, don't give them names. No, nada que Chuy, Albert, y Selena, none of these names. These aren't pets, this is food. Call them Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, if you want. And don't play with the chickens. Don't get friendly. And when she was about to, see, my mother would kill a chicken. And she would grab the chicken by the neck. Nowadays, you can't get a woman to choke your chicken. You know? And talk about people who don't waste nothing, man. My mother would pluck out all the feathers, stuff them into pillows, take the beaks and make guitar picks for my uncles and my father, make rosary beads out of the neck bones of the chicken.
En el nombre de la gallina también.
And everybody knew what part of the chicken was yours. I'm the youngest of 12, so I knew my part was that. I didn't even know until I grew up that you weren't really supposed to eat that cartilage part of the chicken, you know? It's not bone, it's not meat, it's gristle. I used to get that in the chicken butt. Everybody knew, my father, the breadwinner, he would get the breast. You know, my sister, the leg, my other sister, the other leg, my brother, the wing, the thigh, the neck, the, you know, everybody knew their part. The baby, me, I got the chicken butt and the cartilage. And it was delicious. I'd be there going, till my brother George ruined it for me. He goes, hey, you know what you're eating, right? Chicken. Yeah, it's chicken. You're eating the fundillo. What? Oh, it's chicken. Yeah, the fundillo la gallina is what you're eating. I'd ask my mom,
Jorge dice que I'm eating the fundillo, the butt chicken del fundillo. Cállate y cómete tu culito.
Mm.
culito, mama. Cómase su fundillo. What do you think they make McNuggets out of? Go over there. That's chicken meculo they're selling to us. Think we don't know? When it's all said and done, it ain't money you want. It's family and friends. Nothing gets you better than family and friends, man. That's the best. If you ain't got that, you ain't got nothing. I know. I have a large family. I'm the youngest of 12. I asked my mother, how come you had so many kids? She said, but shit, I didn't know all of you were going to survive. Me and your father, we figured half and half, but chingo, you guys clung on to life like a chicle in the sun. I think Mexican parents have a lot of kids because that's their form of social security. They know one of them might make it, and that's what they're gonna live with. Whoever has the most money, that's what they live with. Right now, I'm the lucky one. My family's out of their mind. I used to always run around and telling jokes, and my mother was always, apaciguate. She's a real Mexican, apaciguate. Shut up, quit clowning around. Why are you such a payaso? This is a tribute to my mother, by the way. This payaso cafe. Because that's what she used to call me. Ay, ¿por qué eres tan payaso? You're a payaso. Running around. Telling jokes. Laughing all the time. Life isn't about laughing. I never got that. No, pues, what is it about? It's about, pues, you know, other than just laughing all the time. What could be better, people, than just laughing all the time? No, cabrón, estás riéndote todo el tiempo. You're laughing around. Where is that going to take you in life? Of course, she doesn't say that no more. Now she goes, mijo, no tienes otro thousand. ¿Sabes? Porque el dinero just doesn't go as far as it goes. I love my parents so much. I lost my dad. I didn't lose him. I mean, I know where he's at right now. But see, that's another thing. Our funerals are different. You know why? Because Mexican funerals are catered. There's food. It's like a family reunion and a quinceañera all rolled up into one. Mexican funerals, unlike other funerals for Caucasians, I've been to a couple of white friends of mine who passed away. They're sad. They're there to mourn, as they should be. They're there very solemn, very quiet. They even cry quietly. And the minister goes up and goes, we are here to mourn the passing of Brother Bob. Brother Bob was a great family man, a loving father, all-around swell fella. Let us turn your hymnals to page 69. We shall sing, we shall gather at the river to prevent the Mexicans from crossing. Mexican funerals are different. You know, people walk in there and go, hey, good, hey, 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 I can't believe it, chingo. They ran out of pan dulce. Oh, God. This cheap son of a bitch didn't even have menudo for his funeral. God. I don't care what you suffer from. Menudo cures it all, todo. Menudo's made out of parts of the pig. The pig doesn't want back. You're out there digging in menudo, because menudo looks the same whether you eat it or throw it up. You eat it, you throw it up, you shit it out. It looks the same. You're there munching. There's a lot of homeless people go to Mexican funerals just to eat, just for the food. You don't believe me? God forbid, should your life ever go south, pick up the paper, look at the obituaries. Whenever there's like a grandma who dies, like the Garcias, a Garcia or Gonzalez, you know there's going to be good refin.
They're there, they're eating. We might suffer from a lot of things, but anorexia is not one of them. I got an uncle, man, that's unreal. For example, he shouldn't even be alive anymore. Mi tío Camilo, this guy is a mystery to medicine. He's had three doctors tell him that he doesn't have long to live to get his personal effects in order. And they died. He outlived three of his doctors. The guy used to be in construction, so he's got his lungs have asbestos. And he smokes like a chimney. He drinks, his liver's the size of a raisin. There's no reason for him to be alive, yet he's alive. They made a tracheotomy on him. Fuck, now he smokes through two places. He's smoking one here and he's got one on the waiting deck, you know? And his breath is horrendous. You know, old people have bad breath. And it isn't because they're not sanitary or they don't wash. It's just that no matter how much they clean, there's always a molecule, there's always a particle of something they ate back in 1981 that's stuck in there festering, giving them bad breath. And what is it about people with bad breath? They always want to tell you secrets. The funkier your breath is, the closer people want to get to you. Hey, come here. My uncle's breath is so bad, shit, I know it's him on the phone. My mother calls me up last summer. She goes, mijo, you know, your tío Camilo doesn't have long to live, so I know you got some frequent flyer miles and you're going to France. Why don't you take him with you? You're going to Paris. Take him with you. I said, Ma, I'll do anything for you, Mama. I know, and you're going to do this. There we are, flying. We go to Paris. I mean, the French aren't exactly the most friendly people on the planet. I don't know why they hate us Americans. We've saved their ass every war they've had. And they don't like us. Imagine two Mexicans walking down the streets of Paris, you know? And if you don't speak French, you're retarded as far as they're concerned. You know, we're Mexicans. We're trying to talk to them in Spanish. We figure, shit, you're right next door to Spain. You must have picked up something along the way. Oye, señor, ¿dónde está el Arte Triunfo, la pinche tower, la chingadera, you know? You know the reason why you guys are famous, that shit, you know, like a radio antenna chingadera, what do you call it? Excusez-moi, voulez-vous no parler français? Voy chéquete no su, no comerte un zapato. Mi tío goes, ¿qué dices, güey? You know, what is it about old Mexican men? No matter how old they are, they still think they can throw chingazos. They could be missing a leg, they still want to get into a fight. And every time, they always adjust their pants. Órale, cabrón. Ale, chingado. Ale. And you can see their shit, you know. Their genitals look like steamed vegetables going down there. Finally, we find out where it is. We walk down. We get to the Arch of Triumph, the Arch de Triomphe. And we see La Tour de Eiffel. And my tio goes, well, what's the big deal here? I said, well, that right there, that's the Eiffel Tower, one of the wonders of the world. He goes, that chingadera? How long's it been there? I don't know, since the 1890s. Well, shit, when are they going to finish it? I said, it is finished. No, it's not finished. I've been in construction. They need the drywalling y la chingada todavía. Nobody's gonna rent an apartment right there. Chingadera, I've been to Texas. That's an oil rig. No están chingado que. Big deal. We go to the hotel. We're staying at the Four Seasons, right? I mean, I want the best. If he really is gonna die, I want him to get a taste of the best. You know, we're at the Four Seasons, but we got separate rooms. I got him his room. I took care of him. I'm not in my room 10 minutes. The phone rings. Hey, it's me. Shit, I know. I know it's you. What do you want? Hey, this is really fancy, mijo. Yeah, tío, you know, it's all right. Nothing but the best for my tíos. It's really nice, mijo, but I got this little problem. What happened now? Well, it's really fancy, huh? Yeah. How come they got two toilets? I go, tío, they're not two toilets. One of them's a bidet, That's for the ladies, you know. Híjole, it's a bidet, huh? Sí. What happened? Pues yo creo que me cagué en the bidet. What? Yeah, man. I tried to flush it and it just shoved the shit up my ass. I go, oh, God. It's not a toilet, it's for the ladies. They sit down and the water squirts up there, you know, to clean themselves. Híjole. Pues, what am I gonna do now? I go, listen, don't worry about it. Just call housekeeping and they'll come and they'll take care of it. No, chingo, that's too embarrassing. I'll take care of it myself. I like women of all kinds. When it comes to sex, we're not prejudiced. Latinos are not prejudiced when it comes to sex. You don't believe it? Hispanics come in every color that God ever invented. We are as black as Sammy Sosa, and we are as white, blonde-haired, blue-eyed as Cameron Diaz, Christina Aguilera. The president of Peru not too long ago was Japanese Hispanic, Fujimori. Hey, I went to Juarez last night to eat at a Chinese restaurant. They got Mexican Chinese people in Juarez. I shit you not, we went to eat at a place called El Chino Latino. The owner of the restaurant was named Juan Chon. He was all excited to meet me. Oh, señor, lo ligue, es un placer tenerlo aquí. He introduced me to his wife, Chichona. Their daughter, Chimichanga. Their son, Yanochingues. Their dog, Chicharrón. I can go on all night, and I think I will. America's a land of immigrants. Where else but in a great country like ours can you find a Mexican girl dating an Irish guy, driving a Japanese car to a Chinese restaurant, and be arrested by a black cop? Where else but in this great country of ours? We got a good thing going here. When it comes to the color of your skin, Dr. King said it best. It doesn't matter, it's insignificant. It's the content of your character. But somehow the color of your skin plays so much importance on how much you make. Where do you live? How do you live? Will the bank loan you any money? That's so stupid. I remember going to a bank. My father wanted to borrow some money, and I was his interpreter. And the guy goes, yes, dile que necesitamos dinero. And my father said, he want to borrow some money?
Well, does your father have any collateral?
Apa, dice que si tienes collateral. Pues, el doctor dice que my cholesterol está bien. My father says he's got cholesterol.
No, son, no, explain. And you know, somehow they think we're stupid. Why do you Caucasians do that? When you think that when you talk slower or enunciate, you're talking Spanish, you know. Tell your father if he has any assets.
Papá, dice que si tiene culo.
Pues, qué chingos, what does my ass have to do with this?
Tell him I got 12 culos at home I'm trying to feed.
We can't lend you money unless you have something worth money. Well, in other words, if you have money, we'll give you money.
Dice que no le dan dinero si no tiene dinero. Well, shit. If I had any money, why would I be here talking to this pendejo?
Our parents, because of Catholicism, because of tradition, we never talk to our kids about sex. That's why so many of our young girls grow ignorant and pregnant. We never discuss them because it's a taboo, you know? I remember I asked my mother, I said, Ma, where do babies come from? She slapped me. Ave María Purísima. Cochino desgraciado. Bárbaro grosero. Why do you want to know where babies come from? Because I'm 25. Mothers will never tell you, go ask your father, go ask your father. I asked my father, you know. And my father goes, my father took about 10 seconds to tell me about sex. He said, bueno, tell you.
All I gotta tell you is that you got a loaded gun in your pants now. Be careful where you pull the trigger, eh? Go play, cabrón. Let me tell you something. Here's what pisses me off. America acts like school shootings is something that just started. There have been school shootings in the barrios and the ghettos of this country since our parents were in school. The only difference now is that white kids are shooting. Because they're good shots. These cabrones got good equipment. You know, they're on the internet figuring out the weather for that day, barometer reading, length. They got that laser beam y la chingada. They got camouflage clothing. Fuck, you don't know where the bullets are coming from. And they rack up big numbers. 15 in Columbine, 25 in Arkansas, 30 over there. Shit, they hardly ever miss. You know, when Latinos, when we do our shootings, at least we do it from a moving vehicle in la chingada. We'll give you a sporting chance. Most of the time, the car is bouncing up and down in la chingada. We never hit anybody. We hit somebody's dog in the ass a mile away. Shit. Have you any idea how many drive-bys we'd have to do to hit 15 people? Fuck, I think we run out of gas first. We'd have to have our homeboys push. Órale. Hey, why don't you get out of the car and shoot them, chingo? Me duele la espalda. You're a bad shot, pinche Desert Storm pendejo. I remember I used to ask my father for a quarter, and my father would go, huh, a quarter? Hey, what do you think, I'm made out of money? No, Dad, I know you're not made out of money. If you were made out of money, we wouldn't live in this shithole right here. My father wouldn't just give you money. You want to earn your money? Well, wash the car. See, now recycling is in, but we, Mexicanos, Hispanos, we are the ones who invented recycling because we don't throw nothing away. Go into any Mexican's garage and it's full of shit you're never gonna use again. In a Mexican's home, you gotta earn your keep. Everyone from the dog, very few Mexicans have cats because they're worthless. They don't do nothing. Dog's job is to protect and to serve. You know, a Mexican's dog, his job is to recycle. His job is to eat everything you don't. And with 12 brothers and sisters, our dog had anorexia. We had a skinny dog shaking. He couldn't even bark, he would cough. Fuck it, take the TV, these cabrones don't fit me anyhow. Now when you're gonna wash your father's car, here's what you do, and you know, you go into the house and you find the oldest towel. The towel that's almost transparent. The towel that you could hardly even read, you know, Holiday Inn on there, you know? That's the towel, you know? So I'm in the house, I'm looking for a towel, and I can't find no towel. Now I got six sisters. I didn't know nothing about sex or nothing, you know? So I'm out there trying to wash my father's car, I can't find no towel. I look under the sink and there's a box of feminine towels. I said, well, I don't know what they are. I pull one of these things out. It looked like a bandage for an elephant. It looked like that's what they put on you when you have like a real serious wound. Like, you get your pata chopped off. Bring me one of those Kotex. Let's really stop the bleeding here. As a little kid, nine, I thought, that's what there must be for, you know, for the car, you know? Especially when I took the adhesive tape out of the back, it stuck to my hand. So, I took a bottle of, you know, turtle wax, and I put it on the crotch. And the more I poured, the more it disappeared.
extra absorbent. Sucked up two bottles of that stuff. I waxed the car, left it really shiny. Now, my father's a hard man to impress, but he was impressed. His compadre dropped him off, and he went up to the driveway, and he was, what happened to my car? I said, that's it. But shit, I didn't even know it was blue. I was thinking of selling it. Dad, can I have my quarter? Sí, como no, una quarter. Y un dime, te aventaste. We don't throw nothing away, so I put the little plastic really back on there. I folded it neatly. I put it in the box, put it under the sink, and I went to play. About 28 days later, my sister has this really worried look, and she's telling my mother, my mother's in the kitchen cocinando, tú sabes. Because women can do more than one thing at one time, you know. Man, if we do anything, we got to concentrate on that. Women can be talking on the phone, making tortillas, planchando, ironing, using their toe, going through the yellow pages, looking for a job for their sons or whatever. My sister Griselda comes up, Mama, ¿qué tienes? Mama, tengo un problema. ¿Problema? What kind of problem? I have a problem down there. My mother goes, how far down? Got a problem in the, around the toes? No, higher. The knees? Higher. The belly button? Lower. Ah, cabrona, ¿qué tienes? She goes, I don't know, Mom. I don't know how to say this. A ver, dime, I'm your mother, dime. No estás panzona, are you? No. ¿Qué tienes, pues? Ay, tengo la pussy green. ¿Qué? ¿Cómo que tienes la panocha green? You've been eating too much guacamole, Griselda. What's the problem? You been fucking a leprechaun? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Por qué tienes la panocha green? Ay, Dios mío, tiene la pussy green. I never heard of such a thing. Ay, but does it hurt? No, it doesn't really hurt. And you know what? The hair's really shiny. Thank you, El Paso, Big Chuco. You're the bomb. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Paul Rodriguez.
Me arrullo inconsciente en mi vientre. Los segundos pasados, cargados, tatuados en mi espalda, empapados, aunados a espasmos de llanto y de risa. He andado sin pausa, sin prisa, así de lento el momento. Y no termina así de lento, cruzando entre las espinas.
Dime qué se siente, dime qué se siente, dime qué se siente el sudor en la frente. Dime qué se siente, dime si presientes, dime qué se siente el sudor en la frente.
Sí, señor.
Sonrisa, realidad.
respirar y tranquilo. Estoy en el sitio como para ir a sembrar un poco y después recogerlo poco a poco.
Señor locutor, ¿quiere hacerme el favor de decirme qué hora son?
Son las 4:20, 4:20 minutos.
Gracias, muchas gracias. Y que siga la música en Radio Recuerdo, Canal 86, en Monterrey.
Payaso.